What's up, everyone? In this video, we're going to be talking about the crypto markets and some important crypto news. We did have news with the Fed. I am seeing mixed opinions about this and a lot of people saying we're entering a bear market. So I do want to talk about the possibilities of that and where I see things headed in the short to midterm. Definitely some important stuff happening right now. And we are in the extreme fear in the Bitcoin fear and greed index. So before we get started, I do appreciate if you guys liked the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and hit the bell to be notified for regular crypto videos. So the crypto market is still pretty flat today. We actually did have a quick spike earlier this morning after news that the Fed was delaying interest rates till March. So we can see we peaked out around $39,000 and then quickly came down, bottoming out around $36,400, now on a steady recovery. So we did get news, the Fed Reserve pointing to interest rate hike coming in March. I am seeing mixed opinions, some people stating this hike would come in June or even later. So I do believe that's already priced into the market. I am seeing multiple people saying that. And I am seeing a lot of people stating that we are entering a bear market as well. So even though this type of stuff causes fear and panic in the short term, when you do zoom out in the long term, inflation isn't going to stop because the governments aren't going to stop printing money. We do have to keep that in mind. Looking at a chart like this, you can easily get an idea of this. USD purchasing power and currency in circulation, as you can see, with the decline of purchasing power, the incline of currency in circulation in billions. So this is only going up to around 2008, where we have over $800 billion in circulation. Of course, over the last 2 years with the coronavirus and all the printing to prop up the economy, there is trillions more in circulation at this point. This did cause a huge spike of inflation, and now the government is trying to get this under control before things do get worse. So something bad is inevitable to happen at some point. It's really no saying what is the right answer here. The Fed is trying to get this right. They're delaying the hike of interest rates till March at this point. Some people are stating that's going to be delayed till June or even later. So I do believe fear is already priced into the markets, and I do believe crypto will continue climbing, especially with so much mass adoption on the horizon. All these major companies getting involved, creating their own cryptocurrencies, getting involved with NFTs. The demand is only going to keep rising, in my opinion. So in the long term, they will continue printing billions of dollars, and the purchasing power of the dollar will continue going down alongside of that. Basic supply and demand economics, the more supply there is in circulation, the less purchasing power that will have over time. So this is inevitable, and with Bitcoin having a hard cap on the total supply, with purchasing power of the US dollar going down, with USD being weighed against Bitcoin, that means the price of Bitcoin will continue rising in the long term. As long as something horrible doesn't happen here and does cause mass panic, where everyone no longer wants to hold Bitcoin at all. So we are seeing whales accumulating millions of dollars worth of Bitcoin right now as well. I just posted a chart on Twitter that did show someone buying $2 to $10 million worth of Bitcoin every couple of minutes. While retail investors are dumping right now out of fear, whales are scooping up millions of dollars worth of cryptocurrency. So I think it's important we do look at what the whales are doing instead of what retail investors are doing, because retail investors act more out of emotion, while whales are acting more out of logic and looking at the very long term. So Bitcoin is still in extreme fear in the Bitcoin fear and greed index. I don't see that changing anytime soon unless we do enter a general uptrend moving forward. I do think that would take some very bullish news, like a major corporation acquiring a large amount of Bitcoin or some major breaking news that does really turn things around. So this is important to watch if you are new to the crypto space. Generally, when things are in extreme fear, people are usually selling, and when things are in extreme greed, people are generally buying. If you can reverse that psychology, you generally are a better trader. You're taking profits on the way up when things are in extreme greed, and you're buying on the way down when things are in extreme fear. And going forward in the very long term, when you do zoom out, like we stated, inflation is only going to continue, and the rate of adoption fundamentals for cryptocurrency is only rising in the long term. So checking out the Bitcoin chart, we can see that Bitcoin has entered this accumulation phase here once again. The last time we were at this price was around mid-July before we did get that reversal. Everyone at that time was saying we were entering a bear market. Every single comment I got on YouTube was telling me I was misleading people, that I should just admit we were entering a bear market. But we have to keep in mind this is an extremely volatile space, and anything can happen based on major news. The news that did cause that reversal was Amazon, just a job application showing that Amazon was showing interest in creating their own cryptocurrency. as well as that meeting with Elon Musk and Jack Dorsey, where Elon Musk did state that SpaceX did acquire a large amount of Bitcoin as well. So we're once again in that phase here, and it is going to take something bullish once again, in my opinion. We do have a lot of major corporations building for the metaverse, NFTs, and crypto. NFTs are doing great right now, but cryptocurrency isn't doing that great, especially with this news of the Fed and regulations and tax laws being considered also. So it's always a possibility we enter a bear market. If we do, this will continue, and we will break down below that major support level here of around $30,000. We only briefly went below that a couple times last time during the summer when everyone said we were entering a bear market, but we did get that reversal, breaking and touching new all-time highs for Bitcoin of around $69,000. So things can go either way here. Nothing is guaranteed. You shouldn't believe anyone that tells you anything is guaranteed. In my opinion, though, when we do zoom out for the very long term, we're only going to be going up. And I do think this is a good time personally where I will be dollar cost averaging and accumulating. If we do enter a bear market, I will continue accumulating as well. Where I got my best deals was here throughout the bear market. I was buying here as well before we did have that peak. And unfortunately, I didn't take too much profits during that peak because everything was so bullish. Extreme greed here. When we were peaking, everyone said we were going to $100,000 Bitcoin. XRP was going to $10, all kinds of crazy predictions at that time. That just didn't play out, and we did enter a bear market. But the crypto space was not at all prepared at that time as well. So that is another thing to consider. And I don't think if we do enter a bear market, it's going to be a multi-year bear market like we saw previously. There's just too much mass adoption now, and too many major things happening with the NFT crypto space, and too much accessibility coming for us to enter an extended bear market like this once again. So if we were entering a bear market, I don't think we would be going as low as the previous bear market here, where we were around $3,000 to $10,000 Bitcoin for 3 to 4 year period of time. I don't think we'll ever have another bear market that's that long. Eventually we do have to enter a bear market though, but it probably will be much more temporary and shorter. So if we did enter bear markets over the next 6 months, I do think we would settle here around $20,000 to $30,000. As you can see, that's a higher low than the previous one. That's generally how the crypto space works. Every bear market does have higher lows, and that's why you should be looking at this for the long term. And if we do enter a bear market here, that's going to be where you actually get your best opportunities. And that's where you're going to be able to pick up your best deals for the long term, which is why I always stress, if you are new to the crypto space, don't just jump in, expect quick gains and then disappear. If we do enter a bear market, that's when you should be most prepared, which is why I always stress having a good entry and exit strategy, dollar cost averaging. Don't FOMO in all at one peak price. Spread things out just to play it safe. And in the long term, you're much more likely to be much more successful buying the dips. So I really don't think this is going to happen here where we do enter a bear market with Bitcoin around $20,000 to $30,000. Of course, it's always a possibility if the government comes out and announces some really bad tax laws or something, or regulations on cryptocurrency. That makes everyone panic sell. We could be entering a short-term bear market, but like I stated, I don't think it would be a 3 to 4 year bear market like previously. It'd probably be a shorter one of 2 to 12 months. So I do believe eventually the power that the government and Fed has on the crypto markets will be shrinking, and just how Elon Musk's power over Dogecoin has been shrinking as well. This article states, fading power, weak Doge spike after Elon Musk makes McDonald's offer. So previously, if Elon Musk would have made this offer back in May, Dogecoin would have pumped 50 to even 100% in a short period of time. We did see that previously. Him just posting memes about Dogecoin would pump the Dogecoin cryptocurrency. Now making a big promo offer to McDonald's, only getting a small pump of around 3 to 5%. So his power over the crypto markets has been shrinking. Same thing will happen with the government and regulations and stuff as time goes on. The effect won't be as large on the crypto space overall, just like we saw with China banning Bitcoin. The more times they did this, the less effect it did have on the markets. So that is a good thing. As the crypto space develops, it does get less volatile, but at the same time, with less volatile markets, there's also less profits to be made as well. So personally, I don't think we're entering a bear market right now. We're currently looking a lot better than we were in the summer, and I was still very bullish back then as well. Even though everyone said we were going to be entering a bear market, we recovered to new Bitcoin all-time highs. There's an extreme amount of volatility in the space and manipulation as well. And we have so many major companies getting involved and so much stuff happening for mass adoption. I do not see us entering an extended bear market. A short-term bear market is always possible though. and anything can really happen in this space. Just keep that in mind. No one's going to be right 100% of the time. You should always do your own research, make your own financial decisions, and don't invest in extremely volatile markets like this with money that you can't afford to lose. So that's it for today's video. I hope you guys found it useful. Please let me know in the comments below what your thoughts are on the markets, if we're going to be entering a bear market, or if we're going to continue and break new all-time highs throughout 2022. So tomorrow I will be doing a video on Ethereum and why I believe Ethereum can flip Bitcoin in coin market cap sooner than expected. People have been talking about this for years, but I do have some data and news I do want to talk about why I believe Ethereum actually can be flipping Bitcoin throughout 2022 or 2023. So that's it for today's video. I hope you guys found it useful, and I'll see you guys in the next one.